There is a significant difference in screen structure between flat and curved screens on phones. A flat screen protects the LCD through a bracket, while a curved screen uses a frame to protect the LCD. This curved design makes it more difficult to refurbish. Today, REWA Lab uses the undamaged Samsung Note 10 to share tips for refurbishing the glass. The tools needed for refurbishment can be purchased on the REWA shop. Firstly, test the display and touch functions. To avoid damaging the phone, it is necessary to remove the components before separation. Place the back cover of the phone facing down on the heating pad, and set it to 90 degrees for heating. Remove the back cover, motherboard, battery, and other components in sequence. It is recommended to store the removed parts and screws in a fixed position to avoid loss. After dismantling all parts, we proceed with the separation operation. The glass, AMOLED, and frame of the curved screen are bonded to each other, requiring two separations for the glass refurbishment. Firstly, separate the glass and AMOLED. Create notches on the screen to enter the cutting wire to separate the glass. Due to the screen flex cable at one end of the phone charging port, we will only polish two notches on one end of the camera to avoid screen damage. Place the screen facing up on the separation station and heat it to 90 degrees. Then, use a sharpening pen to stick close to the glass and move the pen in a small circular motion. Do not stay in the same position for a long time, grinding the glass with the pen for 1 to 2 seconds each time. Use alcohol to cool down in order to avoid burning the AMOLED due to high temperature. Stop the operation immediately after grinding out a notch. Drip in alcohol. Use a brush to clean the glass shards. Use a knife to pry up the glass shards, and then use tweezers to remove the shards. At this point, we can see a corner of the AMOLED from the notch. The other uses the same operation to create a notch. We recommend using 0.028 mm cutting wire because coarse wire can easily damage the AMOLED. Due to the curved edges of the screen, press the wire with a knife to smoothly fit into the gap. One hand assists in positioning the wire along the gap of the frame, while the other hand pulls the wire outward at a 45 degrees angle. As the area of the wire separation glass increases, the resistance will increase. We can switch to another angle to continue the separation. Pull the cutting wire in one direction as much as possible. Gradually separate and remove the glass. To ensure smooth subsequent operations, it is necessary to ensure that there is no residual adhesive on the AMOLED. First, use a glue remover to roll up a larger area of adhesive. And then use a sponge dipped in N-heptane to remove the adhesive. Next, separate the AMOLED and middle frame. There is a layer of frame tape between the AMOLED and the frame that needs to be separated. Samsung Cured Screen uses double-sided tape to bond the frame and AMOLED. So separation requires certain skills. Firstly, drop alcohol onto the edge of the frame. Then use a razor blade to press against the frame. And separate one side of the tape from the frame. Next, use the blade to press against the AMOLED and separate the other side of the adhesive from the AMOLED. Finally, use a blade and alcohol to pull out the separated frame tape. Then, while dripping alcohol, pull off the adhesive around the middle frame. There is still adhesive on the back of the AMOLED. So we need to slide an OCA film under the AMOLED to separate it from the center frame. Pay attention to the position of the flex cable on the back of the screen and operate with caution. Remove the AMOLED and clean both sides to proceed with the lamination process. We usually use molds to align the glass and LCD. This method is not prone to errors, but different models of phones require different molds, resulting in higher refurbishment costs. In this video, we share the techniques of manual alignment. First, use a pull tape to tear the protective film of a glass plus OCA. Align AMOLED with the glass, and keep the camera hole on the glass aligned with the AMOLED. Adjust both sides of the frame with fingers to ensure that the glass is partially laminated with the AMOLED, preventing misalignment. Then put it into the machine for lamination and debubble. To prevent the recurrence of bubbles, it is recommended to use a UV lamp to cure the screen, with a curing time of 30 seconds. Finally, we will perform a phone recovery. Remove residual adhesive from the middle frame. Apply the original 3M adhesive and align the screen with the middle frame. Install the motherboard, battery, and all components. And finally stick the back cover and press. There are no issues with the testing function. And this refurbishment is completed. Summary of key points for this refurbishment. For more refurbishment skills, kindly visit REWA Academy.